Welcome back to my kitchen. Today we are making a key lime pound cake with a key lime cream cheese glaze. The ingredients that I'll be using for this wonderful cake, I'll be using 3 cups of swan's down cake flour, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, and about 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Now I've already put the baking powder and the salt in my 3 cups of flour. I mixed it up just a little bit and then I sifted it one more time. Now the cake flour, swan's down, it comes pre-sifted. But once I add the baking powder and the salt, I like to just sift it one more time. You'll also need 3 cups of sugar. I have 5 eggs here that are room temperature. And I've already cracked those. They are large eggs. We have 1 cup of milk that is also room temperature. And then we have 3 sticks of butter. And they are also room temperature. I left that one in the pack, so you would know that it's butter, not margarine. Let's see. Of course, it's a key lime pound cake, so I have limes. Now, you guys, I promise you, my limes did not come looking like this. I thoroughly washed them, just like I thoroughly washed my hands. Don't be in the kitchen with nasty hands, because that's just nasty, okay? So I thoroughly washed my limes, because I needed to grate them to get the lime zest. And the lime zest is right here. I'll be using a little bit of that in my cake. So I got my lime zest. And then I also needed to juice them. I tell you, I juiced the doggone juice out of them too. So this is the juice that it yielded from these two. I don't need a whole lot of juice because, and wait a minute, I want to add a little bit of that to my, I want to save a little bit of this lime juice for my glaze. So let me set some aside, because honey, I promise you, I'd be like a guy and dump all of it in the cake mixture. So I'm just setting a little bit aside for my glaze, and hopefully I won't forget. Now the extracts I'll be using, I'm going to use at least 1 teaspoon or more of vanilla. This pure vanilla extract. And then I have some pure lime extract. I'll be using at least 1 teaspoon or more of this. You guys know I love my cream bouquet. It has that citrusy undertone. I'm going to be using maybe 1 teaspoon of that. And then I want my cake to have that little lime hue, that color. So I have some lime jello, and I'm just going to add just enough to give it the color that I want. It's not necessary, but you know, you can use food coloring if you want to, but I thought, why not just add some lime jello in keeping with the key lime pound cake flavor. Okay, so I'm gonna add just a little bit of that to give me the color that I want. And let's see, I think that is everything. Well, as far as the glaze, I'm gonna be using powdered sugar, and then I have some cream cheese here that I'll be using for my glaze. And you guys, believe it or not, I'm gonna bake this in a different pan, and I'm not using Baker's Joy today, so we'll talk about that a little bit more once we get to that. So let's start getting the cake mixed up. Just looking to make sure I've not forgotten anything. Okay, I think that's everything. So let's start getting the cake mixed up. Now my oven is currently preheating to 325 degrees. And I'm getting ready to talk you through what I'm doing so I won't have to talk over the mixer. So we're going to start by adding these 3 sticks of softened butter to my mixer. This thing right here. Mixer. Add the 3 sticks of softened butter, and I'm going to beat those maybe about 5 seconds or so just to kind of mix up the butter. And then you will see me slowly adding the sugar. So we have to cream this butter and sugar. I cream about 10 to 12 minutes. Yes, I do set a timer. You really want to make sure that you get it creamed. You want that sugar silent, okay? You don't want to hear those little sugar crystals. Once I get the butter and the sugar creamed, I'm going to add my 5 eggs one at a time. You will see me add the first egg, and you will see me add the last egg. But remember, I've added 5 eggs in all. I just don't want to try to talk over the mixer. So once we get that done, then we'll come back and we will add everything else. Now that we've creamed the butter and sugar and added the eggs, it's time to start adding our wet and dry ingredients. I'm going to be alternating my flour with my milk, okay? You always want to start with your dry ingredients and you want to end with your dry ingredients. I'm also going to add my flavorings to my milk, just to go in and get those in there, so make sure I don't forget, okay? Like I said, we're going to do about a teaspoon. You can feel free to do more, teaspoon, tablespoon, whatever tickles your fancy. But I'm going to start with my vanilla, and we're just going to go on and pour that in, making sure you guys can see. That's my vanilla. And then here's my lime. So again, we're going to alternate that flour with the milk. You start with flour, the dry, and you end with flour. I'm going to go on and just sprinkle a little bit of this Jell-O in here in the batter so it can just be mixing while we're mixing everything else. If I feel like I want it a little darker, then I'll just at some point add some more. Again, if you prefer not to do this, you can just use a little food coloring and get your green, but this is what I wanted to do, and then I could just save the rest for some Jell-O. Okay? Let's see. Oh, I almost forgot. Once I pour this down, this is kind of full right now, but I'm also going to be adding my lime juice during this process with my liquid as well, okay? So you'll see me start by adding the dry, and then you'll see me add some liquid. I'm not going to bore you with that whole process, and then you'll see me come back adding the final little bit of flour, okay? But I'll make sure that you see me add some milk. I'll go on and throw the zest in there so you can see that, okay? All right, let's finish getting her mixed up. Mentioned that I'm using a different pan, cake pan today, and that I'm not using Baker's Joy. I've mentioned before that I have a local cake supplier right here, and I took her cake, the owner, I took her cake baking class years ago. It was definitely over 10 years ago. That's when I really realize I do not like icing in cakes. So after taking her class, I purchased a couple of her bundt cake pans that she sells in her store. And also during the class, she showed us how to make a pan release that we can use for our cakes as opposed to using a spray. So this is the pan. It's a bundt cake pan. Yes, it's all one piece. And this is the pan I'll be using today. Again, I've had it for over 10 years. I have two of them, and I've not used it in years. So when I talked to her yesterday, I went in to buy some supplies, and we started talking about cakes. I thought, you know what? Let me pull my pans out. When I told her I had to use my pans, she said, shame on you. So I thought I would pull it out today and use it. And I did my cake release, which just consists of flour, all-purpose flour and vegetable oil. If you want more information about that, let me know in the comments and I can talk a little bit about that in my next video, okay? But I've already used my cake release in my pan. So we're just going to add the batter. We're going to bake this on 325 degrees for about an hour and 15 minutes. Oh, and I forgot to mention, I ended up using that entire box. That's a 3 ounce box of lime jello. I used the entire box to get this pretty mint green color. I didn't think I was going to need all of it, but I did. So I wanted to tell you that before I forgot. Use the entire box. Now you want to make sure your cake is as level as possible. Let me hit it on the bottom to release air bubbles. Once again, my oven is preheated to 325 degrees. I always bake on my middle rack, and we're going to leave her in for, like I say, about an hour and 15 minutes, okay? And when you're baking, it always will depend on your oven as it pertains to how long it's going to take something to bake. But I would say definitely check it maybe about after the first hour if you're not really sure. You guys, I'm definitely going to have to get used to this cake pan, because when I tested my cake about an hour and 15 minutes, it was not done. So it's been in another 20 minutes. So this cake has baked about an hour and 35 minutes. So the timer's getting ready to go off now. So we're going to take it out, let it cool. Definitely cook longer. Okay, so while it's cooling, really quick, we're going to make our cream cheese, our key lime cream cheese glaze. And I have about about 4 ounces of cream cheese. About half of this was already gone. So we have about 4 ounces of cream cheese. Just going to mush this up a little bit before I add my powdered sugar. As always, I don't measure when I do my glaze. I don't use a mixer. I always do it by hand. So I will be adding, if I was to try to give you a measurement, let's see, maybe about 3 cups of glaze. 3 cups of powdered sugar. Here's my little bit of lime juice. And then I want some of my cream bouquet in here. Okie dokie. Oh, and I need some. Oh, let me get a little bit of milk. Again, as always, you want to add just a little bit at a time, because once you get the liquid in, you can't take it out, okay? I want my glaze to be kind of thick. Because I want to pretty much really cover the cake, okay? And starting out, I like, when I'm mixing, I like it extra thick. Because that way I can smooth out, need some powdered sugar, I can smooth out the glaze. The thinner it is when you're mixing it up in the beginning, the harder it is to try to smooth it out. Like I say, I never use a mixer for this. Definitely smooths quicker without the cream cheese, but especially when you just use the powdered sugar and water, or powdered sugar and milk, okay? So that's done. Okay, so we're gonna let this cool. I didn't set the timer. set it. Usually let it cool about 10 minutes. I'm going to set it for about 7 minutes, okay, before we flip it. Now this feels so different than my other cake pan. I'm so used to using my old school cake pan, y'all. Ooh, it's hot. Hot, hot, hot. See, it looks different too. Okay. Alrighty then. So she has to continue to cool before we put the glaze on, because otherwise with it being hot, the glaze is just going to run off. And I want the glaze to kind of stick like an icing, so I need it to be totally, totally cool. Guys, I've let the cake cool for 2 hours. Let me let you see it up close. And to be honest, I mean, it's fine, but I'm just so used to my other cake pan, my old school tried and true cake pan. And so that's the one I prefer to use, but you know, this one is okay. So, but now I'm getting ready to glaze it. And again, I wanted this heavy glaze. Because I wanted it thick like icing. So we have our key lime pound cake with our key lime cream cheese heavy glaze. You put all the extra glaze down in the hole. Okay, then, guys. Pretty green color. Now this is a pretty color green too. Let's see. I can eat some without me.
What you doing? What you doing?
Hey, wait a minute. Don't do that. I just said I can eat some without him.
What you doing? You trying to, you know, I got this vibe that came through this. This vibe came through the city.
You scared me.
Are you gonna try to do this without me? I thought we were supposed to be in this together. You supposed to be, man, I thought I was supposed to be doing this.
You was in the room.
I think you tried.
I just knew. Oh, you scared me.
You changing on me, baby. You changing.
Y'all, that is, you know you ought to be shaming yourself. You don't even know what kind it is.
It's green. It's good.
Y'all, look.
What is this?
And it's key lime. And I put the extra glaze down on the inside. Okay, you're going to have to look up so we can get the thumbnail, Greedy Monster.
That's good.
Sometimes I be struggling where I'm going to put the words because your little head be in the way. Okay. You a trip. Instead of me using my regular pan, I used my pan I got from Miss Lou. I'm going to go back to using my other pan, y'all. And I almost kind of wish I had tried it using the Baker's Joy, because you, wait a minute, you ain't even saved me none. You were standing eating.
I thought you said, man, listen.
I was trying to taste it till you scared me.
Listen, I'm not just eating for me, Donna. You got the people. I'm doing this for them.
We did. We did the apple pie pound cake. Anthony, talking about you took one for the team with the ice cream too.
Yeah, I mean,
baby, I'm trying to do better. I'm not gonna eat a whole piece of cake. Can I please taste the little corner? Listen, I'm gonna need you. I want some with the icing. It's got a cookie.
A cookie. That's good. You did.
It's like it has a cookie.
God, I hate to do this for these people. Listen.
Stop saying God.
Okay, gosh, baby, listen. I don't want to do this.
Okay, be quiet. I was going to say something. Okay. You interrupted me. You made me lose my train of thought.
These people.
Oh, I was saying it's like it has a cookie, kind of like a cookie crumb coating on it. And I'm sure it's because of my Pam release that I use. Mm-hmm. And so, anywho, I'm going to use the Baker's Joy.
These people.
And I'm going to use a raw, my other cake pan. That's just what I want to do.
Let me feel y'all
that's
in
what I
something,
use.
People. Let me tell y'all this. Now, I know, guys, if you guys could be here to do this for me, y'all would. And I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this at all. I'm watching my figure, but for you guys, I'm going to make sure.
I'm going to punch you for everybody that get tired of you saying that because you're not putting on no weight. I'm going to punch you
baby,
for
baby, I'm working on these people. I'm going to do this for you guys. Just for y'all. But I ain't doing this no more. This is the last time I'm going to do this one.
Anywho, y'all.
For this cake.
Thank y'all, Summer. We appreciate y'all so much. Y'all are wonderful. Y'all are wonderful. I mentioned going to my cake supply place yesterday. So, for those of you that comment, some of you send me pictures of your cakes. I so appreciate it. I have some thoughts, and I'm working on subscriber giveaways. So, you guys continue to comment. Like I said, I've got some things in my head that I want to do. I picked up some stuff when I went to the cake supply place yesterday. There's some more things that I need to pick up and get a nice little goodie basket. Something together to
for subscribers only.
And it's just there are a few already I have in my head that I know I want to send something to, but just you guys continue to comment.
Hey, let me ask you guys something.
And show me pictures.
Who was it, baby, that was it Finest Wine or was it Anthony that had the bake off?
Oh, Finest Wine was talking about a bake-off.
Listen, dude, if you're doing your business, make us proud, man. Make us proud.
I told him, I said, you better do the doggone thing.
Make us proud, Finest Wine. Do your thing. Show them how it goes, baby. Let us know how it goes.
So, again, thank you guys so much. We certainly appreciate your support. If you're not subscribed, and a lot of you guys watch and you're not subscribed, you guys, please hit that subscription button. Give us a thumbs up. It really helps our channel out. It lets the algorithm know that, you know, it helps the algorithm to suggest and recommend our videos to other people. And we are working towards that 100K subscribers by the end of this year. Okay, so you guys help us out. We appreciate you all
so
much.
The algorithm need to teach people to do what?
Shake something.
Yeah. What?
There you go. You always trying to read me.
Shake something. Just shake some. Just shake some. Just shake.
I say it don't make no sense for nobody to get this doggone excited about some food. But I'm trying to cut back and do better,
y'all. I'm cutting back too, y'all.
Listen, I'm getting a little too pudgy.
I'm cutting back, but what I'm going to start doing, I'm going to take off the back. But right now, I'm going to cut me another piece of cake. Let's go.
Thank you, guys. Subscribe. Turn on the notification bell.
Just shake something.
We already look forward to you joining us again next time with the Nosy. That's Micah Child Nosy. Bye.